Hey guys, Reza here from Budget Audio Reviews. Today we'll be bringing you the KB Ear Lark, okay? So, thanks to KB Ear, they've sent me this review unit for me to have a listen and have my impressions on it. So, before I run any reviews, I like to put in at least about 10 hours of listening time on the IEM before I give any impressions on the NBBA group or on this video. So I'll be running through. I made some notes so that this video will be a little bit more systematic in terms of the way I bring the impressions to you. Before we get straight to the sound and all that, this is the notes that I've made. So the KB Ear Lark impressions after 10 hours of listening. My test stack is with UAPP Tidal, fed through my Samsung Galaxy S10, which is this camera right here. And then through the Apple USB-C DAC, you know, the tiny dongle DAC, and fed through the Bluebird U3 Mini Amp. Let me bring that up on the camera. So the USB dongle DAC plus this amp is so far one of the best mobile setup I've had. You know, it gives very good tonality and natural sound. So it's not harsh or metallic or overly bright. So even the simple thing, this is about Singapore $15. That's about US what, $11, $10. This is Singapore $40, and in US dollars is about US $30. I've put this rubber skids here so I could put it on my mobile phone. It doesn't slide around. It's light, it's small, it's just like a cigarette box size. I don't smoke, but yeah, roughly this is about a cigarette box size. This goes right up on the back of your mobile phone. Just strap it a rubber band, whatever, and go through the USB DAC. And this is a fantastic mobile setup that I use with all my IEMs right now. You know, it doesn't cost much. Under what, US $40, it's about US $40, and super good sound, and it helps to bring up the life of all your IEMs. Okay, so for today's review is with this guy going through, and the Lark is passing through that stage through UAPP and Tidal. Okay, and the test tracks is back to my older earphone test tracks playlist, which I've created on Spotify and I ported over to Tidal. And here are the notable tracks. They are JoJo by Moroder, Hotel California 1994, MTV Live. Let's bring this right here, yeah. Okay, and That's What I Like by Bruno Mars, Go, Chemical Brothers, Ship of You, Ed Sheeran, Guess I'll Hang My Tears Out to Dry by Seth MacFarlane. I love that track. And Tamakun, it's a guitar track, acoustic guitar track by Rodrigo y Gabriela, Canon in D, and that one is from the Denon Essentials album, fantastic. 18 and Life by Skid Row. Okay, so let's get right to it. Alright, I just want to get the cons out of the way before we talk about the other good stuff. Alright, so I'm just gonna leave my notes here on screen so you can read along with me. Alright, so I've shared this on the NBBA group on Facebook as well. So you can see the cons here is immediately fit and comfort. I find the nozzle is a bit too long, so let me plug out this guy here and show you guys. Okay, so this is my index finger. I've got like average Asian size hands. Check out the nozzle length. Okay, check out the nozzle length. All right, it's long. All right, on top of it, from the shell design, it protrudes out from the shell and outwards a little bit more to the top of the nozzle here. And check out the width or diameter of that nozzle as well. It's really fat and big. I find this design very different from others I've used, you know. So this one, if it goes in my ears, all right, so plus with the, where's the ear tips, must have fell, okay, the ear tips are here. So with the ear tips, all right, this thing goes in, it doesn't sit all the way in, all right, it sticks out right out about there. And then you have to angle it a little bit here. So the whole IEM, the whole Lark will stick out the ears sideways this way. All right. And this faceplate here, it doesn't go flush with your ears. It sticks out way out. So maybe if you think about it as a cool looking accessory coming out of your ears, it's okay. But to me, I just find it really uncomfortable to feel something just hanging by this, and then everything else is outside of my ear. So getting that out of the way, the fit and comfort is the primary issue with me. So if I use the M size tips, it goes all the way in, but it's kind of loose, you see. So it goes all the way in, and then some parts of it will be touching my ears as well, which gives some hot spots. So I don't know, from a design perspective, I think this thing could be improved. Also, the nozzle material is quite hard. So I've used the BGVP VG4 Art Magic tips. You know, it catches on to the inside tube of the ear tips, and if you try and pull it out, it looks like as if it's going to tear that whole tube out. So I think you know, some improvements in this nozzle design is something that you could look forward to. Alright, and even if I use foam tips, I have a similar issue. So I thought foam, I could insert it deeper and get a better grip or something, but somehow it just still doesn't work well for me. Yep, so that's done for the cons, and I've spent about what, 5 minutes on it. 3 minutes. Alright, so the other con would be what I would like to say. It's like a spicy trebles. It can be a pro for some of you, but for me it's a con because the 6 to 8 kilohertz range, it seems a little bit hot and boosted. So it makes your percussion sounds well spicy, and the splash cymbal sounds really hot. So when the cymbals go, so it sounds like a frying pan, you know, going straight to your ears, you know, when you fry, deep fry stuff, and you go, you know, you get that sensation that it's really heating up your ears. So it's a little bit uncomfortable for that range. You could go through it and feel quite all right. Some adjustments with the foam tips will help tame that down a little bit, but generally that signature, the lark signature of that splash on the 6 to 8 kilohertz is there. So it gets a little bit harder and worse on EDM hi-hats here, as I mentioned. So the snare drums can sound a little bit hard on the crack, you know, it's hard, it hits you hard. Hi-hats on EDM tracks are again, it sounds like you know, deep frying some stuff, yeah, or you're doing stir frying food. To me, I think I the analogy is like really hot wok stir frying. Okay, so that's out of the way. So we'll talk about the pros, which is price and value. So this thing out of the box, all right, so let's take a look. Out of the box for US$30, yeah, so US$30, okay, you've got, wow, the first thing I like was this case. Yeah, this thing spoke out to me. I think this case is really cool. You know, nice, good zipper, good shell, protects your IEM, and this, check this texture out, man. This is really cool. I think besides the normal boring all black, this denim look, I think K Bear did good on this guy's here. Next, as soon as you pluck this guy out of the fancy print, I love the print here. You know, one of the reasons I don't throw this box, because this print is so beautiful. Check that out. They did great on the graphic design here. What do you think? Yeah, so all the necessary info is here. You can go or get all this online. Next is the box. Fancy premium feeling looking box. It's a flip top box. You've got your IEM here, you've got the lug inside, you've got the two sets of tips. I believe one is like a vocal tips, one is like a regular tips, right? And yeah, I think they did great with the whole presentation from you know, user unboxing perspective. I think this is quite an experience for me for Singapore $40, US $30. Next, we talk about the construction of the shell. You know, solid looking thing with this faceplate, the plastics here, they all look very good and very solid. Just you know, back to fit comfort and design. Yeah, the cables are all right. So the cables are fairly thin cables. I don't know what they are. I think it's probably silver coated or something like that, but they're okay. They're manageable. They're not unwieldy. They don't feel like they're out of control when you're using it. So cables are fine. The tips are fairly comfortable, but I think, again, it's back to that nozzle design, which I thought is kind of weird-ish. All right, let's move on. Moving on to where we go. Yeah, okay. So moving on to the timbre of the IEM. So we have a very natural sounding you know, sound coming out from the lark. I think it has no metallic sheen to it, which I like. So because some you know, chi-fi yeah brands coming out, you get a lot of that harsh metallic sheen, like Kinara Sif is one of them. KZ's, I like the EDX, I have it, you know, it does have that metallic sheen a little bit. This one, no, you don't have that metallic sheen. Nice, good job on the tuning, KB. KB ear, K-Bear, from here onwards, let's call you K-Bear. Tone is got, here I find this one has a very unique tone. It's got a tone almost like a tube-like, because I did have a stack which included the FX Audio Tube 03, which is a tube buffer. So this had almost like a tube-like sound coming right out of the IEM. So I liked the overall tone that's coming out of this, minus if I don't care much and don't focus on that 6 to 8 kilohertz zone, they are actually very, very good. I really enjoyed the sound of the KB ear. Sorry, I'm just moving these things around so I can sit this guy here, hopefully. Okay, cool. Next, so the soundstage and imaging, it's narrow and intimate. It's not a wide sounding IEM, but because of that, it sounds like it's in a nice little studio. All your performances are performed very well, right for you in a small space like this, which is good. You know, I think it's a very intimate kind of a performance. Imaging is good, and I can tell where the specific instruments are coming for Hotel California 1994 and PV Live. Everything in place without feeling the need to really look for specific instrument locations. So sometimes you may find the imaging of certain earphones a little bit hazy. You have to kind of focus where they are. This guy's good. You know exactly where the instruments are. Next, we're looking at the... Oops, crap. Where is that? Next, we're looking at the bass. Alright, next we're looking at bass. Where are we at? Yep. So bass, yes. Sub bass is fantastic. You get that nice boom, rumble down low, so you have that feeling of sub bass below. Mid bass is a little shy, it could be boosted a little bit more for that body and thump to the sound. Mids, the Lux mids is really interesting for me as a beginner into this current audio hobby right now. So the mids for the Lux, they are nicely forward in my face, which is very refreshing. But it needs a little bit more of that body we talked about, a bit more meat to the sound. Other than that, it's very good. I find the Lark performs very well with male vocals, surprisingly. So I thought, because most of the other IEMs that I had, you know, the latest one, which is the Eco OH10, sounds lovely, but most of the IEMs I have, they perform well for female vocals. But these guys, I thought that they perform well for male vocals, especially Seth MacFarlane's voice is quite interesting, because on, for example, the OH10, for example, the i4 even, or the BA5 even, his voice can sound a little bit airy thin, but here you get that nice raspy texture of Seth MacFarlane's voice on the lark, which I thought was great for male vocals. The lark doesn't have that upper mid glare that irritates my ears. Fantastic. Initially, I thought that 6 to 8 kilohertz spicy treble thing we talked about earlier on was upper mid glare. I was wrong. I went to YouTube, took some test tones between, you know, the different frequency ranges, and I realized that it's not that lower, it's not that upper mid lower trebles, it is this 6 to 8 kilohertz range here that caused that kind of discomfort for me. And yes, nylon strings are so well rendered on the KB Air Lark, on the KB Air Lark. So if you listen to Tamakun, for instance, it sounds really, really, really energetic and forward and alive. You know, it's very upfront, and I fully enjoy that track on the Lark. Trebles, besides that 6 to 8 kilohertz spiciness, the trebles I thought sounded very pleasing with good airy extension up top. Violins on Canon in D help their pitch very well without sounding shrill, because some IEMs with a little bit more treble extension or boosted trebles, you do get the higher ends, the higher pitches of the violin sounding very shrill. This guy doesn't sound shrill. It's nice. It sounds natural. It sounds like a wood instrument. So that timbre we talked earlier on, that natural timbre, yes, this guy's played very well with that natural timbre of the violin. Yes, it also holds very well for older rock and metal recordings. For example, Skid Row's 18 and Live. If you've listened to that particular album or Skid Row's recording during that time, you know the sound. It's that very, I don't know how to explain. It sounds a bit nasally like this, right? So if it's got that nasally sound with that boosted upper mids, it's gonna kill me. But so for this one, nope, I did enjoy 18 and Live very, very well. It doesn't sound shrill, neither does it sound sharp on certain earphones. For example, like the C Audio Yume, I dumped in quite a bit of money on the C Audio Yume, but was really disappointed to hear tracks like 18 and Live. I couldn't enjoy my classic rocks and all that. So C Audio Yume genres start to shrink by a lot. But on the luck, you've got a much wider range of songs that you can enjoy or genres that you can enjoy on the luck. Okay. Next, on 18 and Live, the vocals were kept very well together. Snares didn't have that spicy edge, although it did have that spicy edge, but it's bearable. It's all right. Coming to worse trebles, I've heard way worse trebles. I've heard way worse trebles on there we go, on the TRNVX right here. Yes, I've heard way worse trebles on the, for example, the TRNVX. It's really, really, really very hard treble extension, very sharp S, and the sibilance, it's very extreme on the TRNVX. So let's summarize. We are at the end of about the 17-18 minutes video. I hope you enjoyed this time. In summary, I do like the Lark a lot in terms of the sound, but you know what? It's just that the fit will prevent me from using it often for longer. So if I'm commuting, I need these guys to be really, really comfortable for me. But unfortunately, it's not one of the most comfortable IEMs I have, and it's not something that I want to stick in my ear for a good hour and a half or so. 45 minutes go, 45 minutes back, that kind of thing. So yeah, maybe it's just a comfort issue for me personally. I think I find this something that is not comfortable, but sound-wise it's good. So let's go through the bit of scoring here. I decided to do a bit of scoring. Pros is 5 out of 5 in terms of the scoring. Timbre is 4 out of 5. Tone is 4 out of 5. Soundstage 4 out of 5. Bass 4 out of 5. Mids 4 out of 5. Trebles 4 out of 5. Back up here if I come back up, and one more score here for comfort, that's 3.5. So the Lark scoring got killed because of the comfort here. So overall score is 32.5 over 40, which I think is decent and good for something right out the box with so much value given to you in terms of a nice cool case, nice good unboxing experience. You can keep this box for other stuff. You know, you don't have to throw this away, because you can put, you can use this as an organizer for your ear tips and whatever. Empty it out, hollow it out, use it for something else. Yeah, you can obviously use this box for some other thing. And for decorative purposes, I love the design of this box. I'm not gonna throw this away. It's so cool. I'll be keeping this. Yeah, so okay guys, that's my take on the KB Ear Lark, K-Bear Lark. It sounds very good on its own. If you could pair it with something simple like the Bluebird U3 Mini, you could put it together with the Apple DAC, you will have a wonderful sounding IEM if it fits well for you. If it doesn't fit well for you, for me, maybe maximum 45 minutes and you want to take it out, or you have to consistently adjust up and down, because once that nozzle goes into your ear canal, you feel this upward pressure coming up into your ear canal, and your ears feel like womp, 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 womp. It's not so not so comfortable. All right guys, thanks so much for watching Budget Audio Reviews. Thanks so much for watching my KB Ear Lark. I'm on a new setup here on my Samsung Galaxy S10 with the Lavalier mic plugged to it and the LED light right on top. So I think this is quite a good portable setup on the Zomay tripod. Super good, very stable setup for me, and I can focus on talking to you through the camera. Thanks so much guys. Let's like the video, share and subscribe. We'll see you next time.